Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Students, so in this video, now we are going to discuss continuation of plant breeding for disease resistance. So here, by using of a plant breeding technique, so we can develop so disease resistant in plants. So in previous video, conventional methods I have given. Now in this video, so second method, mutational breeding, now I am going to explain. So along with this particular concept, so few other concepts also now we are going to discuss. So this particular topic or this particular video, very very important. So try to watch this video, so until completion of this video. Okay, so let us have a look on this. So let us continue to study. Okay, now plant breeding for disease resistance. Okay, plant breeding for disease resistance. So in previous video point of view, so here there are two methods are there now. So one is conventional breeding method and one more is mutational breeding method. So there are two different types of breeding methods are there, or two different types of techniques we can be taken. One is conventional and one more is mutational breeding. So here conventional plant breeding methods in previous video only we have discussed. Now so mutational breeding, now let us study. So mutational breeding important for public examinations as well as NEET examination point of view. Now mutation. So mutation is a process by which genetic variations are created. One more time you see there. So our knowledge point of view, our subject point of view, we will study now. Mutation is a process so by which genetic variations are created. So means mutations means sudden changes of which we can be seen in so chromosomal genetic material, a chromosomal order. Okay, so means so in this particular case no. So mutations is a process so by which genetic variations are created. Means so what is the exact genetic information is there now, that one so we will change. Okay, so we will change or we will be bringing off some kind of variations. So these kind of variations now we are creating ourselves. Okay, through changes in the base sequence in the genes. So means here where we are changing, so exactly at changes we are going to take at base sequence. Okay, base sequence within the genes. Okay, when we are going to change the base sequence is nothing but nitrogen bases are there, no, nitrogen bases of purines and pyrimidines. So here binding with adenine with thymine and guanine with cytosine. So that kind of a thing we will change. Okay, now resulting in the creation of a new character, resulting in creation of a new character. So thereby here definitely new characters formation takes place or traits. So means when we are going to change plant breeding for disease resistance. So plant breeding for disease resistance. So there are two different types of methods are there. One is conventional breeding method and one more is mutational breeding method. So conventional method already we have seen in previous video. Now mutational breeding, now let us discuss. So mutation is a process so by which genetic variations are created. Mutation is a process. So there mutation itself, it is a kind of a process. So by using of this mutation process, so definitely we can bring genetic variations. So means genetic variations we can create through changes in the base sequence, through where So changes in base sequence. Base sequence is nothing but which one? So nitrogen on bases we can see now. So here definitely we can bring some kind of changes in base sequence within the genes. So resulting, sir, suppose if we are changing any kind of mutational changes or base sequence, so what is happening, sir, means, so once you see the resulting in creation of new character or trait. Okay, so means definitely resulting in the creation of a new character. So means when we are going to change the nitrogen base sequence, so within the genes, so definitely results in the formation of new characters or new traits. Okay, means these are all not found in the parental type. Means here what is the information now I am going to take now. So first of all, we are taking one plant. So in that particular plant, now we are going to change the base sequence. Means we are going to alter. Okay. So when we are going to change this particular base sequence, automatically, definitely we can create new varieties or the new characters. Okay. So when we are going to create the new characters, definitely it leads to the formation of new plant. Why here it is a new plant means, so there what is the plant we have been produced annually, no? So there new characters we can observe. So those kind of new characters which are not present in parental type. I'm a point you understood, huh? So simple thing, one more time I'll explain. So try to listen carefully. One plant we have taken. So in that plant, no? So what we are doing, changes we are doing in base sequence of the or within the genes. So when we are going to take or when we are going to change the base sequence within the genes, so definitely results in the creation of new characters or new trait. So which are not found in the, it is possible to induce the mutations artificially. So it is possible to induce the mutations artificially through use of chemicals or radiations like gamma radiations. So means here in this particular case, now what is information? So definitely these kind of mutations are made possible. So definitely we can do that, or we can induce the mutations artificially through use of chemicals or radiations. So means here we can bring the mutations by two different types of ways. One is by using of chemicals and one more is by using of radiations. So like what are the examples, you know, radiations point of view, gamma radiations. So this one exactly, so this information exactly I have taken from the textbook itself. So try to listen carefully, ma. So next one, and selecting and using the plants that have the desirable characters as a source in breeding. So this process is known as mutational breeding. Okay, so after completion of bringing of mutations and selection and using the plants that have desirable characters as a source in breeding, means after completion of mutation breeding or after completion of mutations in that particular plant, no, that particular plant now we can be taken as desirable characters plant. So when that particular plant having desirable characters, no, at the time, so that particular plant we can be taken as a source in breeding. So source in breeding, so that particular thing we can be taken as mutational breeding. Okay, so that is the thing. Next one, what is the best example we can be taken, means in a mung bean resistance to yellow mosaic virus or powdery mildew. Okay, ma, for example, what is the example I can give you is, so mung bean. So in a mung bean, so this particular mung bean is resistant to yellow mosaic virus. Definitely this particular mung bean resistant to yellow mosaic virus, and one more is powdery mildew. So means here this particular mung bean has the capability to resist, or it can show the resistance to the yellow mosaic virus as well as a powdery mildew. So this particular mung bean, so we have derived by using of mutations. By bringing of mutations, definitely we have created mung bean. So this particular mung bean has resistance to the yellow mosaic virus as well as powdery mildew. Emma, so this particular example, so you try to remember. So here, this particular mung bean has the capability to show the resistance to the yellow mosaic virus as well as powdery mildew. So why? Because this mung bean we have created by using of mutations. Emma, so now here, up to here, what is the information I have given? No, in a mutational breeding or in mutation breeding, so definitely we can bring mutations by using of chemicals as well as gamma radiation. So or by using of simply radiation. So by using, when we are going to use these kind of chemicals or gamma radiations, so definitely what are the desirable characters which are not present in the parents? So definitely new characters or the new traits we can bring forward. Okay, so how? So by creation of mutations. So suppose if you use any kind of mutations, so for bringing of new characters, so that particular phenomenon only we can be taken as mutation breeding. Okay, for example, mung bean. So mung bean, it has a resistance, or this mung bean variety we have induced by mutations. So that particular mung bean showing resistance to yellow mosaic virus as well as powdery mildew. Okay, ma. So these particular points are important for examinations. So still let us continue to learn under mutational breeding or mutation breeding. Now several wild, this explanation important, try to concentrate once. Now several wild relatives or the relatives of different cultivated species of plants have been shown to have certain resistant characters but have very low yield. So here, what is the point now we are going to learn? No, several wild relatives. So this explanation simply I'll give you. Suppose wild varieties or the wild relatives are there now. So these wild relatives or the wild varieties, you know, definitely having resistant characters. Definitely having resistant characters but having low yield. Okay, so this particular point you don't forget. Wild varieties are having resistant characters but very low yield. So in this particular case, no, hence there is a need to introduce the resistant genes into the high yielding cultivated varieties. That's why now what we are doing. So what are the important characters are there in wild varieties? Means their resistant characters are there now. Now these resistant characters, now we are inducing into the high yielding cultivated varieties. Amma, don't forget now, in wild relatives, resistant characters are there. Emma, these resistant characters, now we are taking from the wild varieties and now we are incorporating into the so high yielding cultivated varieties. So thereby, when we are going to introduce all these resistant characters into the high yielding varieties or high yielding cultivated varieties, automatically what will be happen? So in the next generation, so both characters we can be seen in that particular variety. So there resistant characters we can be seen as well as high yielding varieties also we can be seen in single variety. I'm a point, you understood or not? So that's why. So here, so this is also one kind of a method we can be taken. So for example, resistance to yellow mosaic virus in a bindi. So here in bindi, no, bindi means Ablemascus esculentum, lady's finger is there, no, so that is the best example. So that particular bindi or Ablemascus esculentus, amma, it is scientific name, ra. So Ablemascus esculentum or lady's finger, amma, so their bindi showing resistance to yellow mosaic virus, resistance to yellow mosaic virus. So this particular one transferred from the wild species. So how it is showing resistance, or bindi, how it is showing resistance to the yellow mosaic virus means, so those mosaic virus or resistance of that particular characters we have been taken from the wild species. Emma, wild species. And so when we have introduced resistance to the yellow mosaic virus genes, you know, automatically, so that particular new variety has come. Okay, that particular new variety only we will be calling as Parbani Kranti. Emma, Parbani Kranti variety, how we have been derived means, one more time I'll explain. So try to listen carefully. Now, bindi variety is there. Emma, that particular bindi variety in the scientific name is Ablemascus esculentus. Emma, now, in this particular bindi, no, so we have introduced which one? Resistant genes. So these resistant genes are showing resistance to the yellow mosaic virus. Ipo, when we have introduced disease resistant genes into the bindi variety, no, that particular bindi variety converted into new variety, that particular new variety only we are calling as Parbhani Kranti. Point you understood, Ram? So this one you try to understand carefully. So this explanation here, what is information I have given? So now one more time I'll explain. Once you see there, the resultant to the yellow mosaic virus in a bindi, so was transferred from wild species and resulted a new variety of Ebelomoscus esculentus. So is known as Parbhani Kranti. I hope you understood this explanation. Next one, let us move forward. So the transfer of resistant genes is achieved by, so here simply here up to here what is the thing we have seen? No. So definitely when by causing of mutations or by following of a mutation, so mutational techniques, no, definitely we can bring some kind of new varieties, I told you, no. So but sir, all the time mutations only, so final aspect sir for bringing of a mutational breeding means, so one more thing also is there, that is sexual hybridization, means by following of sexual reproduction also definitely we can bring which one disease resistant genes. So one more time that information only, the transfer of resistant genes is achieved by sexual hybridization between the target and source. Okay, so between the target and source, when we are going to follow sexual reproduction, so definitely we can bring the, so or we can transfer the resistant genes into the target. So from the source. So thereby, so finally what is the thing we will follow now? So here selection method we will follow. So transfer of resistant genes is achieved by sexual hybridization between the target and the source, followed by selection. So this is somewhat information related to the mutational breeding. Next one, mutational breeding later, new concept, that is plant breeding for developing resistance to insect pests. One more time, plant breeding for developing resistance to what? Insect pest. So this explanation also important for neat examination point of view. So try to concentrate well. Now another major cause for large scale destruction of crop plant and crop produce is insect and pest infestation. So another major cause is there for large scale of which one? Destruction of a plant or the destruction of a crop. Okay, by what? So insects as well as pests infestation. So in this particular case, by following of plant breeding methods, now here we are going to develop the, so plants which definitely show the resistance to the insect pests. So let us prepare the, so plants to show the resistance to insect pests. So now, so there insect resistance in host crop, okay, host crop may be due to, so here there are different types are there. One is morphological changes and one more is biochemical and one more is physiological characteristics. Morphological, biochemical and physiochemical characteristics. So there, so here first example, hairy leaf. So here small example, small diagram also I have drawn here. So once you see there on the leaf, no, so there spine like structures, so see here hair like structures are there, no. Hairy leaves in several leaves are associated with resistance to insect pests. Once you see there, suppose here one kind of insect is moving towards the one particular leaf, so that particular insect cannot sit over the leaf surface. Why? There hairy leaves are there, so thereby, so because of the presence of hairy leaves, no, that particular insect cannot sit over there, so thereby indirectly that particular plant having resistance. Amma point you understood, technically you try to understand. For example, resistance to jacid. Resistance to jacid in cotton varieties, no, definitely we can be seen the presence of hairy leaves. So when hairy like structures are there on the surface of the cotton, no, definitely that is only showing resistance to jacid. And one more is seal leaf beetle in wheat. In wheat also, so we can observe a presence of hairy leaves. So definitely that one shows resistance to the cereal leaf beetle. ema cereal leaf beetle is a kind of insect a name of insect idu entire one cereal leaf beetle is a insect name so that one shows that one cannot cannot spoil the leaf of wheat why because there also in a leaf leaf of wheat also showing hairy like structures okay ma next example in wheat one more example in wheat solid stems so the stem is a very solid solid stems lead to non preference leads to non preference by stems of fly ema one more time in wheat solid stems are there so because of the presence of a solid stem in wheat it is non preferable to the stems of fly it is one more kind of insect name stems of fly means when that particular wheat stem is very solid no this particular stems of fly so cannot pinch or cannot make the hole of that particular stem automatically that will not preferable so it is so hard so I cannot do anything so likewise that particular stems of fly will move off from there okay next one more thing and smooth leaved and like nectarless okay and one more is smooth leaves also are there suppose so smooth leaf is there that particular suppose if any particular insect come on to the leaf so the because of the droppable nature or because of the smooth nature that particular insect cannot sit over there ema and nectarless nectar is a very less means so insects cannot be attracted okay so insects cannot move towards the so that particular cotton plant so one more time you see there smooth leaved and nectarless so where we can be seen in cotton varieties do not attract bollworms ema do not attract bollworms next one idu important ma for neat examination point of view high aspartic acid and low amount of nitrogen and low sugar content in maize leads to resistance to maize stem borer maize stem borer is a insect name amma okay so means when that particular plant having high aspartic acid and low content of nitrogen and low sugar content so definitely that particular maize plant having resistance so resistance to the which one maize stem borer emma so these are all different types of examples very very important for neat examination so now here somewhat examples now I have given so let us learn these examples once now some released copy varieties bred by hybridization and selection so here conventional methods so by following of a conventional methods so we have produced some crop varieties so which are having resistance to insect pests ema so let us learn examples crop variety and insect pests okay ma now brassica flat bean and one more is okra okra ma so exactly this entire information we can be taken from textbook page number 175 ema so crop variety brassica flat bean okra bindi means ladies finger I told you know so able mascus esculentum that one so brassica variety is pusa gaurav gaurav ema so directly you try to see this video so by keeping the textbook beside to you okay variety is pusa gaurav next one flat beans varieties are pusa sem 2 and pusa sem 3 SEM amma SEM SEM 2 SEM 3 next one okra varieties pusa savani and pusa A4 varieties you try to remember very very important so here brassica variety means pusa gaurav insect pests so which one it shows resistance to the aphids next one flat b pusa SEM 2 and pusa SEM 3 showing resistance to jassids aphids and fruit borer next one okra bindi varieties are pusa savani and pusa a4 there so definitely showing resistance to the shoot and fruit borer so likewise ama this table suppose if you are unable to understand so this table exactly I have taken from the textbook only so you can find in page number 175 so while seeing or while watching this video you can follow this table directly from the textbook now another new concept that is plant breeding for improved food quality ema next a new concept so by using of a plant breeding methods so we can improve the food quality also so we can improve food quality ema so let us move forward to learn so there More than 840 million people in the world do not have adequate food to meet their daily food and nutritional requirements. Amma, neat examination point of view important to try to concentrate very well. So there, more than 840 million people in the world do not have adequate food to meet their daily food as well as nutritional requirements. So definitely, so the here 840 million people or more than 840 million people pavon, they are not having or they are not eating. So which one? Adequate food which consists of nutritional requirements means what they are eating, their food, no, there. So there is no sufficient amount of nutrients or sufficient availability of micro as well as macronutrients. Emma, so there, if for, one more time you see there, if for greater number, 3 billion people suffer from the micronutrients, proteins and vitamins deficiency. So that particular thing only we will be calling as hidden hunger. Means out of 840 million people, so you see there, more than 3 billion people are suffering from micronutrients, and means they are eating food, but that particular food not consist of micronutrients, proteins and vitamins. So definitely those people are suffering from the deficiency of micronutrients, proteins and vitamins. So when they are suffering from the all these kind of aspects, no, that particular thing only our subject point of view we are calling as hidden hunger. You know, when the people are suffering from the lack of vitamin and the lack of food materials and the lack of proteins and the nutrients or the micronutrients, so definitely they are facing a lot of problems. That particular thing only our subject point of view we are calling as hidden hunger, because they cannot afford to buy enough food, fruits, vegetables, legumes, fish and meat. Means they are not having sufficient amount of money or sufficient amount they are not having. So suppose if they have money, means definitely they can purchase fruits, vegetables, legumes, fish, meat, everything they can purchase. But when they are not having sufficient amount with them, no, they cannot purchase fruits, vegetables, legumes, fish and meat. So when they cannot purchase all these kinds of requirements, no, definitely they will suffer from this problems only, no. So means they will eat, but what is the food material they are eating? No, that food material not having sufficient amounts of nutrients, proteins and vitamins. Because of the lack of all these kind of things, no, they are suffering from the lack of or deficiency of all these things. That particular thing only we are calling as hidden hunger. That's why. So here, sir, they are not eating anything, sir. Suppose if they eat some kind of thing also, all kind of nutrients availability is not there, no, at the time. So what are the problems they will face, sir? Means, so that explanation, and now I am going to explain them. Listen carefully. So diets are lacking essential micronutrients particularly. So what are the essential micronutrients deficiencies there, no, in their diets? Iron, vitamin A, iodine, zinc. So these four definitely required for each and every human beings. One more time, what are those? Iron, vitamin A, iodine and zinc. Definitely these four micronutrients definitely required or definitely essential. Suppose these four not there, means then what is happening, sir? Means, so once you see there, increase the risk of disease and reduce the lifespan and reduce the mental abilities. One more time, once you see there, increase the risk for disease and reduce the lifespan and reduce mental abilities. Okay, ma'am. So thereby definitely, so that particular person, very easily they will suffer from the diseases and lifespan will be reduced and definitely mental retardation. So if you give very easy question also, so because of the lack of mental ability, so they cannot give answer. Okay, ma'am. So those kind of problems definitely they will suffer from. Next one, in this particular case, sir, what we have to do, sir, try to give solution means, so definitely we have to switch on to the biofortification. Biofortification means what, sir? Mean, once you see there, breeding crops with higher level of vitamins, minerals and higher proteins and healthier fats. So means definitely what are the crops now we are going to select, no? Definitely all these crops must have higher level of vitamins, minerals and higher protein and healthier fats, definitely must be there. Is the most practical means to improve the public health. Definitely if you would like to improve the public health means definitely. So what are the breeds having so more resistance, or what are the breeds having or consist of, so which one? Vitamins and more amounts of minerals and proteins and healthier fats, whatever in where you will find, no? So such kind of breeds only definitely you have to breed, then only so chance is there to improve the public health. So breeding for improved nutritional quality, breeding for improved nutritional quality is undertaken with the objectives improving. So here by improving these following aspects, so definitely so we can concentrate on the public or improving of public health. Now let us have a look on this. First one is protein content and quality. So second one is oil content and quality. Third one is vitamin content, and fourth one is micronutrient and mineral contents. So here, because of the development of all these aspects, one more time you see there, protein content and quality we can increase. So because of the improvement of protein content and quality, definitely we can concentrate on the, or we can improve the public health and wealth, and oil content and quality, and vitamin content, and micronutrients and mineral contents quality. When we are going to increase and when we are going to increase the content also, definitely we can bring or we can improve the public health. So that is some more information related to the biofortification. So in this video, so what is the information now I have covered, no? Plant breeding for disease resistance. So under disease resistant, mutational breeding I have covered. Next one, in plant breeding for developing disease resistant or developing resistance to insect pests I have covered. Next one is plant breeding for improved food quality. So here in a food quality, so neat examination point of view, still I need to cover some more information, but due to the lack of board or lack of space here, I am not explained that one. In the next video definitely I'll explain about so plant breeding for improved food quality. So after completion of this video, one more video you have to see, so to cover the improved food quality. So thank you students, so watch this video.